सदाशिव समारंभां शंकराचार्य मध्यमां अस्मदाचार्य पर्यंतां वंदे गुरु परंपरां श्रुति स्मृति पुराणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्र भाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेद विभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विधावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। धातु ब्रह्मैव संप्रोक्तो जीव आख्यातमुच्यते प्रकृतिकृसुभन्तारे धातु ब्रह्मात्मने नमः। नारायण परो व्यक्ता दंडम अव्यक्त संभव मंडस्यांतस्तु मे लोकाः सप्तद्वीपा च मे। ओके सो वी वेयर टू लुक एट भाष्य अंडर 418। सो द 18 श्लोक विच सेज कर्मण्य कर्म यः पश्येत् अकर्मणी च कर्म यः स बुद्धिमान मनुष्येषु स युक्तः कृष्ण कर्म कृत्। वन हू सीज कर्म इन अकर्म एक्शन इन इनएक्शन एंड इनएक्शन इन एक्शन ही इज एन इंटेलिजेंट पर्सन और इज अ वाइज पर्सन। ही इज अ योगी एंड ही इज समवन हु हैज एज दो डन एवरीथिंग दैट देयर इज टू बी डन। सो ही हैज नथिंग मोर टू डू। सो दिस इज अ स्तुति। सो देयर वाज अ क्वेश्चन एज टू हाउ कैन ही बी प्रेज एज अ योगी। योगी वी हैव सीन वन हु इज हु नोज कर्म योग इज ऑल्सो योगी। One who is following karma yoga, one who is following jnana yoga is also yogi, sankhya yoga. Thereby second and third chapter define what yoga is and who is a yogi and what type of a yogi. So yogi yukta means yogi that fits well. Krishna karma krit, this is a stuti. I had said that to start with it is a stuti and in the end once one understands, one continues in sankhya, then he will land into aikya, which will actually free the person, thereby Krishna karma krit leading to. So an example is a person who is studying medicine to be a doctor and he is good in his studies, you start addressing him as doctor, you take medical advice from a medical student. Why? He is not an accomplished doctor, is he? But we call him a doctor because he is more or less a doctor, almost there. So bhavi vrutya, what is called bhavishyat vrutya. So bhavishyat vritya, considering that he will become, he will, because he is one in many who has chosen to walk the path, one who has picked the right path, has a guru, and then he is taking it seriously and he is focusing on it the way it has been taught in the sampradaya. So he is bound to reach it, reach the goal, thereby considering bhavishyat vritya, meaning considering that he will be free, Krishna karma krit, or it is a stuti. We'll see more in the bhashya. And it was introduced as kim puna tattvam karmadehe bodhavyam vakshami iti pratijnyatam. And Bhagavan has said that I will tell you that knowing which you will be freed. He has also said that. He has said that ashubhat, mokshase ashubhat, yajnyatva. So the nature of karma, yat tattvam nyatva, कर्मणः तत्त्वं ज्ञात्वा कर्मणां तत्त्वं और कर्मादेः तत्त्वं यद् बोद्धव्यम् व्हाट शुड बी नोन विच आई विल टीच यू दिस इज अ प्रतिज्ञा डन बाय भगवान एंड ही हैज आल्सो सेड दिस वी हैव टू रिमेंबर यद् ज्ञात्वा मोक्षसे अशुभात् फ्रॉम पापा यू विल बी फ्री फ्रॉम दैट काइंड ऑफ अ बाइंडिंग कर्म यू विल बी फ्री एंड यू विल गेट मोक्ष दिस इज अ प्रतिज्ञा दैट भगवान हैज डन नोइंग कर्म इटसेल्फ सो देयर बाय इट इज पाथ ओपनिंग अप टू मोक्ष. It is like entering a tunnel which you will finally end up in. So there is a light, there is light at the end of the tunnel. So with that in mind, let's look at the bhashya now. Karmani, karmani, karma yah pashye, that karmani means what? Kriyate iti karma means what? It is karmani vitpatti. That which is done is called as karma. Anything which is done is called as karma. In Vaidic context, that which should be done is called as karma generally. So in karma, in laukika prayoga can be any karma, but in Vaidika context that which should be done, which is ordained is called as karma, and nishiddha also considering that what is ordained, Vaidika Nishiddha is also called as karma. Then Laukika is secondary meaning from the Vaidika perspective in the Dharma Shastra. So Kriyati iti karma vyapara matram. In this context here, any Vaidika karma or Laukika karma can be taken as vyapara matram. Any vyapara, any transactional activity, any activity basically is called as karma. So karmani vitpatti for karma. Tasmin karmani akarma meaning कर्म अभावम कर्मण अभाव षष्ठी तत्पुरुष कर्म अभावम यह पश्येत वन हु सीज पश्येत पश्येत इज पश्यति यू कैन वन हु वुड सी और वन वन हु सीज पश्येत कैन बी टेकन एज विदिलिंग कैन बी टेकन एज लट लकार इटसेल्फ पश्यति यह पश्यति कर्म कर्मण अभावम यह पश्यति कस्मिन कर्मणि सो तस्मिन कर्मणि अकर्म मीनिंग कर्माभाव यह पश्येत एंड अकर्मणी च इन कॉन्ट्रास्ट अकर्मणी च कर्मा भावे कर्तृतंत्रत्वात् कर्मा भावे मीन्स कर्तृतंत्रत्वात् मीन्स तंत्र हियर हैज द मीनिंग ऑफ बेसिस कर्ता इज द बेसिस फॉर विच सो कर्ता और कर्तृतंत्रम कर्ता तंत्रम यस्य कर्मणः सह तत्कर्म कर्तृतंत्रम मीनिंग व्हाट A person has a choice with respect to karma. One has a choice. You can choose to do, choose not to do, or you can choose to do alternatively. In different ways are there. So karma has base is dependent on. So tantra can also be seen as dependent on. It can be seen as being dependency. So it karma has dependency on karta. Karma cannot get done on its own. So, karta has to choose whether he should do the karma or not do the karma and how to do it. Thereby, Shastra, when it says there is a karma to be done, that's why we say kartavyam, maya kartavyam, I should do it for its phala. And then, how it has to be done, we go through the Shastra process, describing the process as to how I can do it, what are the accessories for it, what tools do I need. Karana iti, so karakas I need to know, and then what is the phala. Therefore, kartru tantra, karma is kartru tantra, and here since I can choose not to do, therefore karma abhava. Akarma can be mean karma, karma abhava. Karma abhava means karma bhave. Akarmani karma bhave, karma yah pashyet. Sa buddhiman manushya. So, akarma it would be what? Being kartru tantra, that karma. I can choose not to do, thereby it becomes karma abhava. Akarma is karma abhava. Pravritti nivrityoho, kartrutantratvat pravritti nivrityoho. Not only in karma I have a choice, but not doing it, meaning in nivritti also I have a choice. So pravritti nivrityoho, karmana in karma, karmani or akarmani, pravritti nivrityoho, kartrutantratvat. Now he says, vastu aprapya, vastu is Brahma here. वस्तु अप्राप्य एव हि सर्व एव क्रियाकारकादि व्यवहार अविद्या भूमौ एव ही पुट्स अ कमेंट देयर एज टू निवृत्ति सिंस ही हैज मेंशन निवृत्ति निवृत्ति इज आल्सो कर्तृतंत्र सो निवृत्ति इज आल्सो कर्तृतंत्र मींस टू विथड्रॉ फ्रॉम अ कर्म आल्सो देयर हैज टू बी अ कर्तृत्व भाव बट अ सन्यासी एज एन सन्यासी इज अ पर्सन हु टेक सन्यास ही डज नॉट हैव सो मच ऑफ कर्तृत्व भाव If he is taking vidvat sannyasa, he has no kartrutva bhava. In fact, it is the natural state. In Aitari Upanishad Upodghata, Bhagavan Bhashyakara discusses it. It's a long discussion as to how can you say person takes sannyasa. He may not take sannyasa. Why should a jnani take sannyasa? Jnani may not take sannyasa. He can remain as a grahastha also. So there, Bhagavan Bhashyakara says no. If a person chooses to stay in grahastha ashrama, that is his choice and thereby kartrutvam is still there. Whereas sannyasa is not, he is not taking by choice. What is happening is that he is withdrawing from karma, the karma is dropping off on its own because he does not see any use in it. So there Krishna karma kriti is in the real sense. That time what would happen? He says the natural state is sannyasa. Atma has no karma adhikara, it has no karma relation also, no, it is asanga. Thereby withdrawing into Atma, one would take to sannyasa, it is a natural process. because bhiksha, he has to survive only on bhiksha. He has to only survive, and for survival, bhikshatana is the only option left, which is but natural. So therefore, nivritti, when he talks about nivritti, sannyasa is indicated, and when sannyasa is indicated, Bhagavan Bhashyakara clarifies that sannyasa should be taken for vastu. For vastu means brahma, and vastu aprapya, aprapya eva hi sarva, not attaining that vastu, not having not attained the vastu, person considers oneself as a karta bhokta. If one has attained the vastu, then one will not consider him as a karta bhokta. So nivritti, in nivritti by a person choosing to withdraw from karma, like Arjuna, who does not he has not attained the vastu, so vastu prapya he is not doing nivritti, he is not withdrawing from action, attaining the vastu, but not attaining the vastu. Not attaining the vastu, what is the case? Vastu aprapya vihi sarva eva kriyakarakadi vyavahara, sarva vyavahara. Any transaction which is there, if you have not attained the vastu, whether it is pravritti or nivritti even, that nivritti is also what? Kriyakarakadi vyavahara avidya bhumau eva. All vyavahara, whether it is in kriya, karaka or any adi, kartrutva ityadi, all vyavahara is avidya bhumau eva, in the avidya bhumi, in the field of avidya. So nivritti, when taken without understanding the vastu, that is also having kartrutva bhava there. Karma yah pashyet, so akarmani karma yah pashyet, mean karma bhave kartrutantratvat, having a choice. Why kartrutantra? Because vastu aprapya. This is the reasoning given. He explains that, particularly says that, otherwise this comment is not needed. This comment is needed here because Bhashyakara wants to show that sannyasa, vidvat sannyasa, or that nivritti that he has mentioned, is not kartrutantra, so to say. It is a little kartrutantra is there, but it is not so much so. In vidvat sannyasa it is not, but in vividisha sannyasa, wanting to know the vastu, if one takes sannyasa, there is kartrutantra there, but a little kartrutva only in saying that one has paroksha jnana, and then one has to one wants a paroksha jnana, therefore one drops off all karma. Karma yah pashyet, pashyet is what? Pashyeti. So lat lakara, not vidhiling, can be seen as lat. Sabuddhiman manushyeshu, manushyeshu sabuddhiman, we have seen all this. Sayukta yogi cha, so yogi also we have seen. Krishna karma krut, Krishna karma krut, samasta karma krut cha. Same meaning, Krishna is samasta, one who has done all the karma. Saha, it is stuyate, it is a glorification, it is a praise, so that once somebody at a very higher authority in dharma shastra, he praises that if you take to this viewpoint, take to this perspective, then you will be such a person. You are, you know, you are like a god. So there is a praise, you know, you say, or even you are god of computers. He is not a god of computers. The computer does not have a god, that's a different story. But considering that god of computers, it's a stuti, it's a glorification. So it's figurative. To start with, it is figurative. It is stuyate karma karmanoho itaretara darshi. This word we have seen, itaretara darshi, one who sees mutual dependency among them. So you see, karma, in karma there is a karma, in akarma there is karma. Nanu, now there is an objection, because literally you look at this, it is contradictory. Therefore, Purva Pakshi asked this question. Nanu, look here, it's an objection. Kimidam viruddham uchyate. What is this contradictory statement made by Bhagavan? Karmani akarma yah pashyediti, akarmani cha karma iti. It is contradictory, seeing action in inaction and inaction in action. Does not seem right. On face value, looks like it's contradiction. Nahi karma, akarma syat. Why is it a contradiction? He further says, if you can't see it, anyone can see this contradiction. Look here. Nahi karma, akarma syat. Never can karma be akarma, never can action be inaction, akarma va akarma, and inaction cannot be called as karma, it can never be so. So therefore viruddham, tatra viruddham katham pashye drashta, how can one see this contradiction as right? एनीवन हु इज सीइंग, द्रष्टा इज अ सीयर, त्रिजंता. सो कथम पश्ये, सो देयर द आंसर इज गिवन, नो दिस इज नॉट राइट, व्हाट यू आर सीइंग इज नॉट राइट, एज इन व्हाट कॉन्ट्राडिक्शन यू आर सीइंग, देयर इज नो कॉन्ट्राडिक्शन एट ऑल. सो भगवान भाष्यकर असे रिस्पॉन्स, पूर्व पक्षी इज रिस्पॉन्डेड टू बाय द स्टेटमेंट, न नॉट सो, अकर्म एव परमार्थतः सत कर्मवत अवभासते गृढदृष्टे हे लोकस्य. सो ही सेज अकर्म एव परमार्थतः सत, बीइंग नॉन नॉट कर्म, बीइंग इन एक्शन इटसेल्फ फॉर आत्मा, आत्मा देयर इज नो एक्शन फॉर आत्मा, परमार्थतः इन द हाईएस्ट रियलिटी फॉर आत्मा, फॉर वन सेल्फ देयर इज नो एक्शन, एंड बीइंग सो परमार्थतः अकर्म एव सन, अकर्म एव सत, सिंस इट इज न्यूटर देयरफॉर सत, अकर्म एव सत, बीइंग शत्रंता, दिस शत्रंता बीइंग अकर्म इटसेल्फ, इन एक्शन इटसेल्फ कर्म वत अवभासते, वत इज वती हियर, लाइक कर्म, कर्म इव, कर्म इव अवभासते, इट अपीयर्स लाइक अ कर्म बिकॉज ऑफ तादात्म्य संबंध विथ शरीर, विथ शरीर देर इज अ संबंध, तादात्म्य संबंध मीन्स आइडेंटिफिकेशन, देर फोर द कर्म विच इज accruing or being done by the sharira is seen as my karma, for whom lokasya mruda drishte, due to the deluded vision, the vision of delusion which is for everyone, lokasya, for the world. So the world's drishti is like that, mruda drishti it is, therefore for that mruda drishti, from the perspective of the mruda drishti, it appears so, but it is not real. Tatha karma eva akarmavat, and similarly the opposite way, karma eva akarmavat, the karma which is seen, that is, that appears as akarma, it appears as akarma. What is karma? Wanting to not wanting to act, not wanting to act itself is a karma, and it appears as akarma. He'll elaborate that further. So this is the opening statement that Bhagavan Bhashyakara has made. Tatra meaning in what he has explained, tatra yathabhuta darshanartham ah Bhagavan. Here what in this shloka, so tatra is in this shloka, yathabhuta darshanartham ah Bhagavan. Bhagavan Krishna has said what? He has said the darshana, the idea, the perspective as it is, what is as it is, what Bhagavan Bhashyakara has explained, akarma eva karmavat avabhasate, but he has not told about what is an appearance, he has said what is real, akarma karmavat avabhasate, but akarma is what? Akarma is the karma, that laukika karma is akarma for atma, and laukika akarma meaning laukika withdrawal, saying that I am not doing anything, that is karma, that is the reality, that is yatharta. So yathabhuta darshana, as it is, yathabhuta means as it is, and darshana artham, the idea, the vision of things as they are in reality, what is that? Karmani akarma yah pashye ityadi, the shloka. Ato na viruddham, ataha therefore it is not contradictory. Buddhimatva dyupapattescha, and further he gives reasoning also, there is another reason also, why is it not contradictory? First, it is coming from Bhagavan, it cannot be contradictory if you have shraddha, but if you are questioning, then buddhimatva dyupapattescha, if you are questioning, what you are questioning, that Bhagavan is saying something else, maybe we have not got it, but you can't take one shloka out of context and interpret. So he says buddhimatvadi upapattescha. See, buddhiman, why buddhiman? If it is contradictory, then he cannot be buddhiman. You take one line and interpret it, you say no, this is contradictory. If you say this is contradictory, then how can it be buddhiman? A person who sees this is buddhiman. So you take half the shloka and say no, it is contradictory. If it is contradictory, then how can it be buddhiman? How can the person be buddhiman? It can't be buddhi, it can't be intellect, it cannot be intelligence if you are interpreting something, you are seeing a contradiction. सो इस बुद्धिमान दिस बुद्धिमत्वाद बुद्धिमत्व इज बुद्धिमान दिस पर्सन बी इज बुद्धिमान दैट इज हिज बुद्धिमत्वम बुद्धिमान अ पर्सन इज बुद्धिमान इज बुद्धि हैज बुद्धिमत्व सो बुद्धिमत्वादि उपपत्तेश्च आदि पदेन दिस युक्तः कृत्न कर्म को इत्यादि सो आदि पदेन बुद्धिमत्वादि उपपत्तेश्च मीन्स ड्यू टू टेनेबिलिटी ऑफ दैट इट इज टेनेबल इफ इट इज नॉट विरुद्ध मीनिंग इट इज यथाभूत दर्शन देन ओनली इट इज पॉसिबल दैट अ पर्सन कैन बी कॉल्ड एज बुद्धिमान योगी एंड कृष्ण कर्मकृत फर्दर इज सेज बोद्धव्यम इति च यथाभूत दर्शन उच्यते एंड भगवान हैज सेड दैट इट शुड बी नोन इट इज नॉट इजी टू अंडरस्टैंड वॉट इज कर्म वॉट इज अकर्म वॉट इज विकर्म सो दिस आई विल टीच यू हैज सेड एंड वॉट इट इज दैट बोद्धव्यम वॉट इज सेड इन फोर वन श्लोका बिफोर वॉट हैज ही सेड कर्मणो हि अपि बोद्धव्यम बोद्धव्यम च विकर्मण अकर्मणस्य बोद्धव्यम गहना कर्मणो गतिः This karma is not easy to understand. So he says you have to understand all three types of what is karma, what is akarma, and what is vikarma. You have to understand that. Therefore he says bodhyam iti cha yathabhuta darshanam uchyate. This is that yathabhuta darshanam which he has promised he'll say he'll teach. Na cha viparita jnanat ashubhat mokshanam syat. Further he says another shloka has gone by. Yajnyatva mokshase ashubhat he has said. Having known this karma, akarma, vikarma, you will be freed from all the ashubha, papa. Because papa is due to hanging on to raga dvesha and doing karma based on those with kartrutva bhava and thereby considering yourself as a bhokta. I will do something and then I'll, if I do this, I'll get more happiness, I'll get more sukha, I want more wealth, all this is. That bhoktrutva bhava is there in the mind that I want to do bhoga, more and more bhoga, that will drive you to indulge in more and more raga dvesha. Thereby you will accrue papa, which is ashubha. And knowing this karma as yatharta, yatharta drishti of karma will free you. So yajnyatva mokshase ashubhat, this is told in two shlokas back. This is told two shlokas back. Nacha viparita jnana ashubhat mokshanam syat. It is not possible that there will be viparita jnana, there will be moksha from ashubha due to viparita jnana. So what you are talking about, had it been contradictory, then it will not lead to moksha from ashubha. It will not lead to freedom from ashubha, papa. If you see something contradictory and Bhagavan is teaching some contradiction, how can it lead to moksha from ashubha? Iti cha uktam, so it has been said so in these two shlokas at least. So now we will see how it is. Tasmat karma karmani viparyena grihite pranibihi tad viparya grahana nivrityartham bhagavato vachanam. Therefore it has to be right knowledge, and for it to be right knowledge, what you know as right has to be contradictory. So what you are pointing out as contradiction, that is right. And you know that there is a contradiction. So if you know you know there is a contradiction and that there is no contradiction, what has been taught and where you see contradiction is right knowledge, then obviously what you know a priori, what you know before this, that has to be viruddham. That has to be viparita jnana, ayatartha jnana. Therefore now he says tasmat karma karmani viparyena grihite, this dual. Tasmat karma and akarma, therefore karma and akarma, viparyena grihite, seen opposite to their nature, prani vihi, by all creatures, meaning human beings, tad viparyaya grahana nivrutyartham, to remove that misunderstanding that you have about karma, due to which now you think that what Bhagavan is teaching is viruddha, to take away that he is teaching. He is not teaching contradiction, he is teaching what you know as wrong. So he is teaching the right knowledge, tad viparya grahana nivrutyartham bhagavataha vachanam, teaching of Bhagavan, what is that karmanya karma yaha ityadi. Nacha atra karmadi karanam akarmasti kunde badarani iva. And now he says, what is your thinking? Your thinking is that in the second case where you say there will be no karma if I'll be an akarta, I'll not be doing anything if I don't do anything, meaning I don't act, I'll not be doing anything. This is akarma, this is your understanding. And in the first case, first half, you said that if I act, then I'll lose akarma and I'll be doing karma. So karma and akarma, the way you see, you are seeing the locus where the action is happening. There you see this opposite nature. So where action is happening, if you withdraw, you will go into inactivity. That is your understanding. So that is what he is explaining next. Nacha atra, and here in this case, karma karmanah adhikaranam. Shashti karma adhikaranam. Karma adhikaranam means karmanah adhikaranam. The adhikarana, locus of action, is not inaction. It is not that from inaction you have gone to action. Locus of that adhikarana, where it is a substratum, meaning you are at rest. Assuming that you are at rest, where there is nothing happening, that is a karma, and on that you build karma. So there is no, it is not the case. So it is not like that. Nachatra karma adhikarana, akarma is not adhikarana for karma. How? Kunde badaraniva. Like, it is not that karma is happening in akarma. Meaning what? See, basically you, if, see, kunde badaraniva means what? The, like berries kept in, some kind of berries or, some fruits which are small, like pebble-like fruits, grapes, or we'll take example of grapes, easily understood. So those are kept in, but you don't generally store grapes in, some dry fruits, consider some dry fruits, which are stored in a pot, in a kunda. So there you will see that these are resting on, so adhikarana is explaining, kunde badarani eva. So kunda is adhikarana for badarani, for berries or for these dry fruits, the kunda is the adhikarana. So you take away the anything that is resting on it, you take away the badarani, it will be empty. So you will say kunda has no badarani. This is the understanding. So he gives an example to draw home the point that this is your thinking. As if this karma is placed on akarma, you are thinking that karma is placed on akarma. If I take away karma, akarma will be there. So he is ridiculing it. Indirectly he is showing for Tarkika, he is showing how the buddhi works and how deluded it is. It has to be like this for you to withdraw into substratum. That substratum you should know what it is. So when you withdraw from action, it is not inaction. So that is what he is saying. Nacha atra karma adhikar karanam akarmasti kunde badranayo. And flip side also, napi akarma adhikaranam karma asti. And karma is also not the locus for adhikarana, for akarma. Karma bhavatvad, karma abhavatvad akarmanah. So he says, this karma bhava that you are seeing, napi karma adhikaranam karma adhikaranam karma asti. Karma bhavatvad akarmanah. Karma has akarma. Akarma that we are saying, that is an abhava of karma. This is the general understanding. So if it is an absence, then you can't have karma as adhikarana for akarma. So this is easily understood. This does not need much explanation, because you don't think that the adhikarana for akarma is karma. But generally the thinking is that adhikarana for karma is akarma. So you withdraw from karma, you will land into akarma. That is not true. Flip side anyway is not true. But he is, for completion sake, he has mentioned the flip side also. Ataha viparita grihite eva karma karmani laukikaihi. Therefore, this misunderstanding is definitely there. What is understood by the people in general, that is about karma and akarma, that is definitely contradictory. That is viruddha. Viparita grihite. Karma and akarma, this is also dvitiya, dvivachana, this is also dvivachana. Karma and akarma are what? Viparita grihita. They are viparita. Karma is understood wrongly, अकर्म इज ऑल्सो अंडरस्टूड रॉन्गली. एग्जैक्टली ऑपोजिट इज द अंडरस्टैंडिंग. यथा मृगतृष्णिकायाम उदकम शुक्तिकायाम वा रजतम. एंड हाउ वॉट इज द मिसअंडरस्टैंडिंग? इट इज अ भ्रांति. इट देर इज अ कॉग्निटिव एरर. एंड इट इज यथा जस्ट लाइक एन एग्जाम्पल. टू एग्जाम्पल्स आर गिवन हियर. मृगतृष्णिकायाम उदकम जस्ट लाइक वॉटर इन अ मिराज वॉटर. बेसिकली मिराज वॉटर इन अ डेजर्ट एरिया. सो इन द डेजर्ट यू सी वॉटर. वॉट इज इट इज भ्रांति. सिमिलरली यू सी कर्म एंड अकर्म. सॉरी यू कर्म एंड अकर्म. दी वॉट यू आर सीइंग हियर एज लोकस ऑफ ईच अदर दे आर भ्रांतिज. शुक्तिकायाम वा रजतम. एंड सीइंग सिल्वर इन नेकर. सो शेल यू सी अ शेल इन वॉकिंग ऑन अ सी शोर इन ब्राइट सनलाइट. यू सी शेल्स लाइंग अराउंड बट दे शाइन. द शाइन दैट यू सी विद इन द शेल इज नॉट सिल्वर बट इट डज शाइन लाइक सिल्वर. सो शुक्तिका इज अ शेल एंड रजता इज सिल्वर. वेरी कॉमन एग्जाम्पल जस्ट लाइक मृगतृष्णिका. दिस इज ऑल्सो शुक्तिकायम व रजतम. और रज्जु सर्प. रज्जु सर्प इज ऑल्सो रज्ज्वाम सर्प. दैट इज अनदर एग्जाम्पल टेकन. दीज आर ऑल टेलिंग यू दैट देर इज अ भ्रांति. इट इज एन एरोनियस कॉग्निशन. ननु अनदर ऑब्जेक्शन. ननु कर्म कर्म एव सर्वेषां न कचित् व्यभिचरति. He says, what is this you are talking about? What you are talking about is a laukika drushti. And what is laukika drushti? It is objective. How can you say that all the people have misunderstood? So he says, nanu karma karma eva sarvesha. For everyone, karma is karma. Why do you say that people misunderstand karma as a karma, karma as karma? So it is not true. ननु कर्म कर्म एव सर्वेषाम. एवरीवन सीज कर्म एज कर्म. न कचित क्वचित व्यभिचरति. डज नॉट चेंज एट ऑल. इट डज नॉट चेंज. दिस आइडिया इज कॉमन टू एवरीवन. सो द रिस्पॉन्स गिवन टू दैट इज तत् न. दैट इज नॉट ट्रू. सो ही गिव्स एन एग्जाम्पल. डू यू रियली थिंक दैट एवरीथिंग दैट यू सी इज रियल? यू सी कर्म कर्म एव सर्वेषाम मीन्स एवरीवन सीज एक्टिविटी एज एक्टिविटी. If that is true, means he is saying yatharta. It is yatharta. Why are you saying that Bhagavan is removing the viparita grahana? You are saying that Bhagavan is removing the viparita grahana means everyone is seeing karma as a karma. But it is not true. Everyone is seeing karma as karma. So Bhagavan Bhashyakara is giving an example which these examples have not reached the Purva Pakshi. He has not understood it. So he says, I'll give you another example which will drive home the point that you think that what is seen as karma is always like that. No vyabhichara. There is no vyabhichara means in Nyaya, if you show vyabhichara, you see activity, you always see activity. You have defined what is activity, this is activity. And then this is karma. And karma sarvesham karma eva. If you have shown that, then if I show you even a single case where it is not true, then you have to accept. And here I have shown the example of bhranti. Bhranti happens, and this is also bhranti which will be proven over the period of the Gita also. It will be proven. But if this is not understood, he gives an example which is commonly understood, which you think as karma. Tatna naustasya navigachantyam tatasteshu agatishu nageshu pratikula gati darshanat दूरेषु चक्षुषा असन्निकृष्टेषु गच्छत्सु गत्यौहा दर्शनात्. सो ही गिव्स टू एग्जाम्पल्स हियर विच आर मोर कॉमनली अंडरस्टूड बिकॉज इट इज इन लौकिक व्यवहार. हियर ही सेज दैट दिस इज भ्रांति. वी ऑल नो इट इज भ्रांति. हाउ इज दिस अ भ्रांति? कर्म. इट इज आउट ऑफ कॉन्टेक्स्ट. इज अ थिंकिंग ऑफ द पूर्व पक्षी. इट मे बी. सो इवन इन अद्वैतिन्स देर आर पीपल हु टॉक. फॉरगेट वेदांतिन्स, अदर वेदांतस. बट in Advaita Vedantins also people think that this Murgatrushnika or Rajju Sarpa or Shuktika Rajata, these examples should not be given for creation. This world, let the world exist the way world exists. Karma also let it exist. But they even many Advaitins don't like this Rajju Sarpa. It is not like Rajju Sarpa, they say. It is like they prefer the example of Mridghataha. So Mridghata, because Srishti Drishti Vadins, mostly they want very detailed explanation of Srishti. Srishti is this way, you know, Bhagavan created elaborately. So there is very lot of Shraddha in the Shruti, which
talks about creative stories. These are all stories, but they hold on to it. This is how the creation is. Bhagwan has created, is all powerful. All that they talk about. We are Alpajna, you have no knowledge of anything, and you are comparing yourself to Ishvara. Why are you questioning Ishvara, Srishti, all this? But the idea is that the Shruti is going to do apuvada of that. This story is just a story. One Shruti talks about creation in one way, other Shruti talks about creation in another way, third Shruti talks about creation in another way, one talks about definite stages, other talks about no stages. So all these ideas are going to be refuted by the same Shruti. Same Upanishad is going to refute that. So that gradually you are taken there. Having understood, you hold on to Adhyaropa, a projection, and don't take to negation, then we have not grown enough in the Sampradaya. Anyway, so similarly here, now we don't expect more from the Puropakshi, although we expect more from Advaitins and Advaita Acharyas to give more weightage to Apavada. And if not more weightage, at least you give equal weightage, at least you give equal weightage to different prakriyas, not hold on to one prakriya alone and call other prakriyas wrong. You hold on to one prakriya is also alright, but do not call other prakriyas wrong. If another Upanishad says that there is no creation, Ajativada, or says that this creation itself is a Bhranti, or it is Jiva Shrishti, do not negate it. They are also true. It may not be for your audience, it may not be for you, but it is not wrong because it is an Upanishad Vakya, it is a mantra. So many ways are there to treat many types of audiences. So this has not gone well with the Puropakshi here. So he says, Nanu karma karma eva sarvesham na kachit vyabhicharati. So there vyabhichara is being shown. Tat na naustasya navi gachantyam satyam. So this is Sati Saptami in Sri Linga. Nau is a boat. So when a boat is going, in the in one direction, let's say it is going northward, so I'm just giving something northward. So then what happens? Nausasya, one who is present in the boat. So the boatman or the traveler, he is going towards the north, and tatasteshu means on the bank, river banks, agatishu nageshu. Pratiparika is naga. Can anyone tell me without looking up the dictionary, can you guess what naga may mean? Naga. If you don't know the word, can you guess what naga means? Agati, which has no gati, naga. What could it be? On the banks, tatasteshu, on the banks, what is it, naga? Yeah, objects. But here, see, naga. Objects is fine, but Vyutpatti Artha, if you look at it, see, Naga, Agatishu, Nageshu, Naga is Upapada Tatpurusha. Na Gachati iti Naga. Generally, Na Gachati. So, Na Gachati, what is it that doesn't move? A tree. So, generally, a tree. This is Vruksha, Vruksha iti Artha. So, Na Gachati iti Naga. So, Vruksha. Very nice vyutpatti, you know, naga. Naga is a vruksha. Tatasteshu, agatishu, nageshu. The trees which are there on the river banks, they are not moving. But what happens? We have the experience, if you have gone in a train, generally you see, modern example would be train. You are sitting on your train is standing on the platform, or it is moving, you think that the opposite. So, to fit the example, let's say your train has started moving. But you look at the other train and you think that train is moving, or vice versa. Any example will work. So it appears to move in the, exactly, it appears to move in the opposite direction. So Bhagavan Bhashyakara is giving the example of a of something which is moving, but the something which is not moving appears to be moving southward. So the when you are going northward, the still objects seem to be moving in the opposite direction. So, naustasya navi gachantyam satyam tatasteshu agatishu nageshu vrikshesu pratikula darshanat. Pratikula means opposite direction, gati. Pratikula gati darshanat. you see opposite movement in the objects which are still. They are not moving. Now, is this Vyabhichara or not? Karma karma sarvesham you are saying, but there it is not true. Just like you can have an error in cognition, you may consider that there is karma in akarma. So there you are actually seeing karma. You think that the trees have suddenly started moving. Okay, one may not think that the tree is moving. However, something which is stationary. In this case, Nageshu will not take Vitpatti Artha. Will take what? A person who can move. So you take a person who can move there, but the person does not move. He may be still, but he appears to be moving. Vriksha is better because we know Vriksha does not move. There you will say the person is really moving. So either case, whatever helps you understand, or take the train example. So this is one example he shown. Now he is showing the other example. Other side, flip side what? This is what? Seeing karma in akarma. Not the way Bhagavan Krishna has said, but this is Vyabhichara, that not that always karma is karma. People misunderstand, they see karma where there is akarma, where there is akarma they see karma. Now this is seeing karma where there is no karma, seeing gati where there is no gati, gati is karma here. Now he says, dureshu chakshusha asankrishteshu. The objects which are very far, far away, like in the sky, you see the planets in the sky. So you see moon in the sky, the moon appears to be still. Dureshu chakshusa asannikrishteshu gachatsu, but they are moving objects. However, with the great distance, you don't see the moon moving. Gatya bhava darshanat, you see no movement in the moon. You say, see, this is where the moon is. Look at the moon, look at the beautiful moon, but the moon is moving. So when there is gati, you don't see gati. And when there is agati in vriksha, you see gati, opposite side movement. So this is the Vyabhichara. So nausta senavi gachantyam tatasteshu agateshu nageshu pratikula gati darshanat dureshu chakshusha asannikrishteshu gachatsu gatyabhava darshanat evam iha api. Similarly here also, akarmani karma darshanam karmani cha akarma darshanam viparita darshanai yena tan nirakaranartham uchyate karmanya karmaya pashyer ityadi. And similarly here also, you already have a bhranti. You think that atma has karma when you act and atma has no karma when you do not act. So not atma, there atma is reflexive in the second case. You think you have karma when you are acting, and you think you do not have karma when you are not acting. This is a misunderstanding. Viparita, that is viparita darshanam, yena karanena tan nirakaranartham uchyate. To remove this misunderstanding, Bhagavata uchyate, Bhagavata Krishnena uchyate, karmani akarmayah pashyet ityadi. So the shloka is due to that reason. Tadetat ukta prativachanam api asakrut atyanta viparita darshanam darshana bhavitataya momuhyamano lokaha shrutamapi asakrut tattvam visvritya visvritya mithya prasangam avatarya avatarya chodayati iti. So he says, tad etat ukta prativachanam api. This idea has been mentioned in the second and third chapter, that atma has no karma. All that has been explained across many shlokas. So this answer has already been given as to what is karma, what is akarma. It has been hinted and it has been told in so many words as well through shlokas. However, so and not once. Tadetad ukta prativachanam api. Prativachanam is answer. Ukta, which has been told. Asakrat, not once, many times it has been told. Atyanta viparita darshana bhavita taya mohmuya manaha lokaha. People who are intensely and repeatedly deluded. So mohmuyamana is yanganta, shows intensity and or it shows frequency also. So muhudatu, you see duplication here, yanganta will take duplication. So mohmuyamana lokaha, world, people, world of people. So loka people, how atyanta viparita darshana bhavita taya, under the influence of this contradiction, being impressed with this idea, contradictory idea, which is very deep rooted. Due to that, what happens? Shrutam api, even if they have heard the answer, even if they have been taught multiple times, asakrut, this, what is that? Shrutam api tattvam, asakrut shrutam api tattvam, that idea which has been taught, which is reality, yatharta, yatharta darshana which has been taught, still what happens? Tattvam vismritya vismritya, having forgotten continuously. Vismritya means every occasion they get to indulge, every indulgence in sense organ is forgetting the tattva. So tattvam vismritya vismritya twice shows that at each and every occasion they forget tattva. And then mithya prasanga, prasangam avatarya avatarya, and bringing this mithya prasanga instead of replacing the tattva with this their faulty understanding. So mithya prasanga is the situation which is mithya, bringing that, giving it reality. So avatarya is actually bringing it forth, meaning trying to face that kind of a situation which is unreal and giving it reality, lending that reality, whereas you forget what is the reality. And thereby what happens? Bringing this mithya prasanga to the mind, what happens? Chodayati. He questions. Every time he questions, what is this? Oh, it has already been told. No, I don't remember, so you teach me again. This is the thinking and this is the case with everyone. Chodayati iti. Therefore, what happens? Bhagavan punaha punaha uttaram, punaha punaha uttaram, aha Bhagavan. He keeps on answering tirelessly. Same idea with other examples, other words. Some way the student should understand. So many ways are used. Durvijñe chancha alaksha vastunaha. And vastu, atma, brahmatma is very difficult to know. Durvijñe, because it is subtle, very subtle. And that's the reason it is difficult to know. We have indulged into given reality to anatma for so long that it is not easy for us to break the habits. Therefore, it is not easy to know our own swarupa. Alakshya, considering that vastunaha durvijñetvam cha alakshya Bhagavan punaha punaha uttaramaha. He keeps on answering it tirelessly, answering all the questions, although the question is very similar. Answer is only one, but he answers it many ways, and that is a repetition which the Shastra also does, considering that the tattva is difficult. Avyaktoyam achintyoyam na jayate mriyate ityadina atmani karma bhavaha. Where has it been taught? So now we can ask, where has it been taught? In second chapter it was taught, 20th and 25th shloka said, avyaktahayam, achintyayam, all this has been said about atma, and you are talking about this karma for atma. There cannot be karma for atma. The avyakta, which is unmanifest, how can there be karma for that? Achintya, so difficult to understand that subtle tattva, you can't even objectify it with any indriya, and you are putting this gross karma across to that atma. How can it be? Not possible. It has been said, na jayate mriyate. So na jayate mriyate, jayate is not born. Na jayate, not born. Na mriyate, does not die. And anything in between, and jayate and mriyate, is what, all sorts of karma. So if one is not born, one does not die, then how can there be other vikaras which are kartrukaraka sambandha, sambandha rupa? Cannot be. Ityadina atmani karma bhava. Karma bhava is karmanaha bhava. Absence of karma has already been shown in atma. There cannot be any association of atma with karma. Shruti Smriti Nyaya Prasiddha, and it is Shruti Smriti Nyaya Prasiddha. You can take in Shruti, Smriti and Nyaya, all three you can take in Prasthanatra. It is Prasiddha. Prasiddha, it is well known. Uktaha Vakshamanascha, it is famous in all that. It is well known in all three Prasthanas. And then Ukta, it has been taught, and Vakshamanascha, it will be taught further in this Gita Shastra itself. तस्मिन् आत्मनि कर्माभावे अकर्मणि कर्म विपरीत दर्शनम अत्यंत निरूढ़म। इसे तस्मिन् आत्मनि, इन दैट आत्मा कर्माभावे, इन विच आत्मा देर इज एब्सेंस ऑफ कर्म एंड विच अकर्मणि कर्म विपरीत दर्शनम, सीइंग इन दैट दैट कर्माभावे अकर्मणि, तस्मिन् आत्मनि कर्माभावे अकर्मणि कर्म विपरीत दर्शनम, मीनिंग सीइंग समथिंग डिफरेंट फ्रॉम दिस अकर्मणि कर्म विपरीत दर्शनम, अपोजिट टू दैट अत्यंत निरूढ़म, यतः किं कर्म किमकर्मेति कवयोपि अत्र मोहिता। दिस विपरीत, ऑल दैट यू से दिस इज वेरी इन रूढ़ी, इट इज देयर एंड इट इज सो डीप रूटेड, सो अत्यंत निरूढ़म, इट इज सो डीप रूटेड दिस विपरीत दर्शन, सीइंग कर्म विच इज कॉन्ट्राडिक्टरी टू अकर्म, विच इज अकर्म इज अ नेचुरल स्टेट ऑफ आत्मा विच नेवर चेंजेस, एंड सीइंग कर्म इन दैट विच इज कॉन्ट्राडिक्टरी टू यथार्थ दर्शन, दैट इज वेरी डीप रूटेड। यतः, वाई इट इज डीप रूटेड, बिकॉज इट इज ऑलरेडी बीन हिंटेड एज वेल, यतः किं कर्म किम अकर्मेति कवयोपि अत्र मोहिता, इवन ऋषिज आर डिल्यूडेड इन द मैटर ऑफ कर्म, दैट इज वाई तार्किकास थिंक दैट सुखा इत्यादि दीज वृत्तिज आर देर इन द आत्मा, दे थिंक आत्मा हैज सुखा, आत्मा हैज दुखा, ऑल दीज इमोशंस आर देर इन द आत्मा, विच इज नॉट राइट, दैट इज ऑल्सो सम काइंड ऑफ कर्म, यू सी सम चेंज देर, so some kind of a subtle kriya is happening, that is not true, and this is the reason already hinted that even kavis are or rishis are also deluded respect to atma, they may be knowing some mantras, they may be knowing, they may be having great expertise in purva mimamsa shastra also, in karma kanda, but when it comes, when the topic is atma, then they are deluded. Dehadhyashrayam karma atmanya adhyaropya aham karta mama etat karma maya asya karmana phalam bhoktavyam iti cha, says dehadhyashrayam karma, the karma which is dependent on the deha, dependent on the deha because it is kartra tantra, and karta is actually the deha, actually the deha, because guna guneshu vartante, what can interact with an object, that alone can interact with the object, so one product of guna is indulging with another product of guna, so dehadhyashrayam karma, karma which is has its basis in deha, all the karakas are in deha, atmani adhyaropya, having superimposed on atma, having projected those that karma on atma, one thinks what, aham karta, so one becomes a kartra karaka because he sees karma in oneself, seeing karma in oneself one thinks I am a karta, aham karta, I am a doer, then mama etat karma, this is my karma, so if I am a karta, then I'll do something more, now I'll do this karma, I'll do that karma, I'll do it in this way, I'll do more of it, all these ideas are further there because mama etat karma, kartavyam karma, whatever it is or should be done or should not be done, thereby one superimposes on oneself the idea of karma, karta ityadi, maya asya karmana phalam bhoktavyam, then one becomes a bhokta also, because this result has to be experienced by me, I have to enjoy this, somehow I have to get it, iti cha, these all ideas are there, so one error of adhyaropa, which is due to avidya, leads to all these series of errors. Tatha, similarly, aham tushnim bhavami. Similarly, the flip side, aham tushnim bhavami means I'll sit silent. Sit silent means I'll not do anything. I'm not in a mood to do anything, so I'll not do anything. Meaning what? I will sit silent means I'll have no karma. This is the idea. Aham tushnim bhavami. येन अहम निरायासः अकर्म सुखी स्याम, ड्यू टू विच आई विल बिकम वेरी हैप्पी बिकॉज आई विल बी एट ईज, यू नो हाउ यू डूइंग, आई एम टेकिंग द डे वेरी इजी, इजी मीन्स व्हेन यू से आई एम टेकिंग इट वेरी इजी मीन्स व्हाट, आई एम नॉट डूइंग एनीथिंग, सो अहम निरायासः, निरायासः विदाउट एनी एफर्ट, एफर्टलेसली, not effortlessly the way Atma is effortless. How? Nirayasa means not by Swarupa. If someone asks you to do something, you, even if you want to do it, I'll do it later. Right now, I am Nirayasa. I do not want to take any efforts. So meaning, I do not want to take any efforts means you are someone who will get affected if you take efforts. If you move from your bed, then there will be some ayasa. There will be some effort involved. And right now, I don't want to put in effort. That thinking means what? You want to withdraw from the effort. Whereas you don't have an understanding of what, that you never had any effort. Whether you do karma or don't do it, it does not belong to you at all. You are not affected in any which way. So, aham nirayasaha, when you say, that is misunderstanding. Akarma, akarma means without any karma. Karma na vidyate asya. So, this is bahuri. Sukhi syam, I'll become happy. Iti karya karna ashrayam vyaparoparamam tatkritancha sukhitvam atmani adhyaropya na karomi kinchit tushnim sukamase iti abhimanyate lokaha. And what is this? This is a misunderstanding. Iti karya karna ashrayam vyaparoparamam tatkritancha sukhitvam atmani adhyaropya. So, one superimposes that sukhitva due to not doing any action. Cessation from action itself is sukha. That sukha one superimposes on atma. It is not swarupa sukha. The sukha is due to lack of effort now. The effort lacking is sukha for this person, and thereby what happens? Na karomi kinchit, I'll not do anything. Tushnim sukhamase, I'll sit silently. And happily I'll rejoice in that state. Iti abhimanyate loka, this is how one considers, wrongly considers really. Tatra idam lokasya viparita darshana apanayaya, to take away, to remove this viparita darshana, misunderstanding, contradictory ideas of the people. Karmani ah bhagwan, bhagwan teaches karmani akarma yapashyer ityadi. So, this is the reason that Bhagavan is teaching that the people have misunderstanding, they have contradictory ideas, so he is teaching what is right and that appears contradictory to those who do not know. We will see the next in the, I wanted to finish this part so that we can move to a different interpretation of the shloka, but anyway, we will continue in the next part. Om Tatsitam Shanti Shanti Shanti. Any questions? Okay. No questions, so I'll see you in the next part. Namaste.